Welcome back, people. It's the local geezers. Back at it again.
Back like we never left. I mean, what, we're on episode three? It's three, right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, three.
Number three. Number three for the fans.
Is it the first one of 2020?
It is, yeah.
So belated Happy New Year to everybody.
Hope you all had a good time.
We did.
And you started the year off right.
Yep.
You know, and you're really finding your stride and finding your feet.
Mm-hmm. Because that's what's important in life, isn't it? Just being comfortable and maintaining that happiness level and, you know, just cracking on with whatever business you've got going on.
It's certainly true, but I'll tell you one thing, and I'm sure everyone will agree. One thing that makes it a lot harder is when you're feeling under the weather.
Well, you know what I mean? By the sounds of it, that's you.
I am a bit bunged up.
Well, this coronavirus talk got me a bit nervous, not going to lie. We had to spray the studio down the other day.
Yeah.
If anyone saw it on the story, they saw Wiz getting right stuck in.
Wax on, wax off.
Wax on, wax off. So how are you feeling? How do you know you haven't got coronavirus?
Because I've been sneezing. And apparently, it's all Chinese whispers, I guess.
Yeah, I like that. Chinese whispers.
It's all Chinese whispers. But yeah, apparently if you sneeze, then it means you ain't got it. So, I don't know. We'll see if I keel over in a couple of weeks and die, then... We know that's propaganda. If I'm all right and carrying on making bangers and that, then, you know.
God is good.
Yeah, God is good. Yeah, exactly.
So to answer me this then. So if you did have to quarantine yourself, what are the five essentials that Wiz will stock up on going into quarantine?
Water.
But it comes out the tap.
No, I don't drink it from the tap. Dirty.
So what about when you take a shower or bath?
Yeah, I don't drink that water, do I? Do you drink your bath water after you've done with it?
Okay. What's number two?
So number two, so I said water, obviously food, some nice vegan friendly food.
We want specifics.
Oh, you know what? It would have to be the Eitel stew still. I just cook up a big batch of Eitel stew and just have that ready there. That's my favourite like soul food meal, like, and it's easy to make.
And what is the Eitel stew? Eitel stew. For those that don't know.
What is that? It's a stew. It's like a vegetable stew, but the base is like stock, water and coconut milk to give it a bit more of a creamier taste.
Okay.
And you put like potato in it, sweet potato, carrot, spring onions, garlic, onion, thyme. It goes off. It's peng bro. Like, I'll make it one time.
Yeah, man. So what is definitely. That? Is that with rice?
It's with rice. Yeah. Okay. You can have it. You can have it with rice if you want to have it with rice, but you don't have to have it with rice.
Okay.
You can just have it on its own as like a stew, or more of a soupy kind of thing. You could even put some boiled dumplings in there. Ooh. If you wanted. That's my next thing that I'm gonna do, just to
pump it up a bit.
Yeah, so that'd be my number two. That'd be the main bit of food.
Two down, three to go.
Three to go. You need some good films or some good content to watch.
So what would you be watching? Home Alone?
No. I'm trying to think.
Premier League years, you know, bit of 2004
yeah,
vintage
football. It's always a good one. I tell you one thing that I did watch the other day, and if I was in quarantine, I could probably watch it again. Or if I'd already been, I've been quarantined, so what I watched while I was quarantined was Noughts and Crosses on BBC.
Okay.
Very good show. It's got Stormzy in it. Only little cameo appearance, but quite interesting. Interesting storyline. Yeah, interesting watch. Yeah, check that out. So, but some good content to watch. Number three. I mean, you could say weed, but like I'm not enjoying smoking weed at the moment. Like with the chest.
Yeah, I can imagine.
And all that kind of stuff. It's not fun. So I'm not even gonna say weed.
Are you honest with yourself?
Yeah. Quilt and cushions, mate, because I've been living in one of them. Do you know what I mean?
Fair.
Like a cocoon.
In a cocoon, caterpillar and that.
Feeling like Migos or some shit. Is that four?
That's four, that is four.
That's four. And then, it's either got to be a hot water bottle or a heater, not a portable heater, but like...
One of those bad boys.
Yeah, that you can just put right next to you and have the heat blowing.
So I'm just going
to
turn off, your face. It's getting a bit hot. Is that alright?
Yeah, no problem.
I think it's actually really
off. Yeah, that'd be the five, I think. You know, it's substance over style with this one.
Yeah, you got to play it safe, haven't you?
You've got to humble yourself when you're ill.
Brings you down to reality, back down to earth, bit of reality, I'm fucked up. I need to get better. Change my lifestyle. I'll be back in a few days.
That's it, and get back onto what's important, you know. Whatever that may be for people, finishing projects or...
Going to your 9-to-5.
Yeah, going to your normal job.
Seeing your grand Judith.
Yeah, giving her a kiss on the cheek and not being afraid she's going to keel over.
All this keel over talk. Oh, Derek, your kisses make me keel over.
I've gone weak at the knees. That's not me, Doug, that's coronavirus.
That's not me, Doug. It's the corona talking. So all this coronavirus talk, I'll be honest with you, folks, it's got me slightly worried. Whereas Wiz, on the other hand, I know, without even asking him, he thinks it's a facade. He thinks it's the media putting it into our brains. Am I right?
Yeah, that's what I think. Like,
I knew it.
At the end of the day, I'm seeing loads of numbers, and like the numbers are like... I mean, more people die from flu each year and stuff like that, I think, or on a certain day. Mm. So, you know, you got that to put into account. And yeah, it happened at too much of a convenient time. You know, everyone's starting off the year, getting themselves on track.
And then bang!
Finding their flow, and then yeah, bang! Pow! Right in the kisser.
Ba-ba-pow!
Pop, pop, bang! Shout out to John Fury, that's what I'm saying.
Tyson Fury, what a legend. The man, the myth. But for me, gone completely onto a different topic here, and I'm not sorry. For me, the real MVP is his dad, John Fury. If you get a minute, if you get an hour, if you get 5 hours, if you're in quarantine and you need that content, John Fury
book
interviews.
A day off work and watch his interviews.
Book a whole week off work and just study that guy. John Fury, if you're listening, mate, great fighting man.
Balls like King Kong and Godzilla rolled into one. Quotables are off the art of this world, mate.
Awesome really. Quotes. Awesome quotes.
But so he's a top lad. Coronavirus is a conspiracy.
Yeah. Fuck coronavirus.
I'm only a couple of minutes in.
Yeah. We're already screaming, effing, blinding, and jeffing.
Have we been swearing?
We haven't been swearing that much. But yeah, for today's show, we actually got a special guest. We should have announced this a bit earlier, but you know, Corona got the best of us.
Keep it a secret.
Okay, we'll keep it a secret then. Yeah. We'll keep it a secret. Without baffling on, I mean, this month has been a special month for me, especially you, Ted, and the guys. You know, we dropped a project. Cognac Arcade is out now. Cheers to that. We've got lemon ginger tea bags, and Wiz has got the homemade one floating about. So we're cheersing up to that. We're going to play a song in a moment. I don't think there's really much to say about it, really.
Not really. Do you want to play the song first?
We just... If you haven't streamed it, go and stream it. If you haven't listened to it, give it a listen if you like it. Thumbs up.
Good thing to talk about then. So let's talk about putting a project together. So you've put one together. I'm putting a project together.
Yes.
We're putting a project together.
We are.
So, let's talk about that.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Hot.
Do you think there's one way to approach it? Or do you think there's 6 million ways? Choose one.
I think there is quite a few different ways, to be honest with you. But I think what's best is what's best for you as an artist and how you work and how you put it together. As you know me, I'm kind of all like a bit just strict on just deadlines and just this done this time, this done that time, and for me that's how I work best. But at the same time, as you know yourself, like you can't when you're creating, sometimes you can't rush the process, else it's not going to be right, and you really need to be happy and confident with the end product because you're the one that's going to be pushing it, performing it to people wherever you go. So I think if you can find a balance in between, you're nice. How do you feel about putting the project together? You've got the tape on the way.
Yeah, man.
Many songs in and out of the playlist.
Yeah, oh, big time. Yeah, revolving door playlist. Do you know what I mean? Because like, I think it depends, doesn't it? Like, because you can either, like you say, you can either end up one or two ways, or come to two conclusions where it's like, okay, I made 10 songs. Now let me turn them into a project.
Yeah.
Which might work. it might not work. It depends on you and what you're trying to say. But I think, like, for me, like, I didn't know what I wanted to say from the start. I didn't know what I wanted the project to represent. I just knew I wanted to make one. Mm. So there was a lot of confusion in a negative sense, but it's like, you'll make a song and you'll be like, yeah, this is a hard song. But then when you actually come back to listen to it alongside these set of songs, you're like, it don't make sense.
Yeah, it's
or
not,
doesn't
yeah.
fit in.
It's not aligned together.
Yeah, it's completely like just out here. It's off the spectrum, do you know what I mean? So I think for me, it was just getting like a couple of songs which I felt had like a certain type of feeling towards them. And some of those songs now aren't even in the
mix,
the pool.
But
from having that, then it's like, okay, I know how I should be approaching the production of the other songs.
To make it fit.
To make it fit
To make it work.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like, sometimes it's like a step forward and then a step back.
But it's like a step back to go forward.
Yeah, which you might end up going two steps forward this
next
time.
Exactly.
It's a fine line between getting discouraged.
Yeah, I hear that.
But being motivated, like, it's fine. But you have to be, as long as you know what's going on,
you're all right. As long as you're aware. Right.
Yeah, as long as you're aware that that's the case. And as long as you get them positive sessions or those songs that come out of it that make you think, yeah, cool, we're on the right track. That's what you need. Do you know what I mean? And then the idea starts to build. That's how it was for me. Had them certain songs, like I say, have a certain feeling, certain vibe. And then I started to think about, right, mindset. What do I want this to be?
I think that's a really good way of kind of like summing it up too. Like, you can't just say you're going to make a project. I don't think you can kind of just say, right, I'm going to make four songs and it's going to be a mini EP. I think it's like,
you can do that.
You
but
could.
That's all it is. It's a mini EP.
Yeah.
That's all it is. It's just for four songs
together. Yeah. What I'm saying is, like, say if you're working on a project, you'd probably have to make 20 songs to get shaved down to 8, 6, whatever. Do you know what I mean? It's very rare that you're going to make the first 6 songs and say, right, that's it. Some people might, but I think, especially at the pace that we record and write and produce or whatever, like, I think that's the best way for us guys anyway. Looking at the board over there of all those songs, that's probably going to get narrowed down. There's 16 songs there. Ted's already came in and got his red pen out and crossed 2 of the fuckers off.
It's all right.
14 songs on the way, local geezers. But more music coming soon, as we're mentioning here. But we're going to play Cognac Arcade, which is track 5 on the tape.
Someone called me.
It's called Cognac Arcade.
Is it?
Self-titled one. Self-titled.
Geezer gang.
I called a barmaid. A little special one. Loco, baby. I ain't bothered if it's half eight.
Low key, I'm a genius when thinking with my had the party rocking how I wish you could have seen this. Wait, no guest list, not bothered but checklist. Find myself an influencer isn't on my checklist. You ain't getting free lunch, so we can spit the bill in a minute when you're done. And that's my last offer. And we ain't gotta chill, don't bother. Beefing over nothing, just return on my clubber. 7 miles running with the moon in the morn, while my personal trainer just abuses my form. Surprised I'm not ripped, I guess it's only day 6. Gym in a gym, I'm always repping A6. Huh, size logic, cause I've been getting chubby from them goodies at the market. No fat shaming, could you blame him? They really can't tame him. I'm the type to still walk to the food shop when it's raining. Keep my voice low about the cash in the attic, and I scream free max, I'm a bigger velly fanatic. Free him up, blah. Can't keep a good nigga down, you get me? Cognac Arcade, so go ahead whiz and call the barmaid. Drop a little splash of brandy in my latte. Yeah, I'm a savage, I ain't bothered if it's half eight. Cognac Arcade, so go ahead whiz and call the barmaid. Drop a little splash of brandy in my latte. Yeah, I'm a savage, I ain't bothered if it's half eight. Yeah, I'm out here for a sick time, but you won't catch a man snitching like 6ix9ine. Rap boy, twat boy, never like cheese boy. My name's Delroy, never been a decoy. Power through gangs to raise your peas in the sky. Yeah, I grind at all times, I'm like a thief in the night. And when you man went left, I had to skirt to the right. And if you killers didn't know, well I'm a geese till I die. Bad bees on my line, wait, she's not my type. Twerking on the gram, is she feeling alright? Dedicate myself to these beats when I write. I lost my head for a year, cause getting lean was a vibe. bottle after bottle, like living a lie. Fussy or the Henny, I can't even decide. Sometimes I wish I had an ordinary life. All I want is a house, a kid and a wife. Cognac arcade, so go ahead whiz and call the barmaid. Drop a little splash of brandy in my latte. Yeah, I'm a savage, I ain't bothered if it's half eight. Cognac arcade, so go ahead whiz and call the barmaid. Drop a little splash of brandy in my latte. Yeah, I'm a savage, I ain't bothered if it's half eight.
Wow. Tell you what, mate. Well done on that one.
Cheers, pal.
Cheers for giving me a shout out too.
No probs. I would shake your hand, but with all this corona, yeah, do an elbow.
Yeah, big elbow.
You want an elbow?
I want an elbow.
Give me one. Come on.
Then. Yeah. So the special guest, introducing, well, so many different names. We like to call you Gunfingers, but how do you best like to be known?
I like. It's Medley P, to be honest, bro.
Medley
I think
P.
That's like the new. When I meet people, though, I still say my own name. Depends on who it is. Like, obviously, if it's a bird, I ain't gonna turn up to him and be like, "Yo, my name's Medley P." And like,
why not?
I don't know, man. I think it's different if you've got Jimmy as like the thing. I can't turn around and be like, "Yo, it's Medley," but like, what's going on?
Yeah, but you can set the bar from the,
yeah,
the
set
start.
It from early, because then what happens in a couple of like weeks' time when she's feeling you?
Then give out the governments.
Yeah.
You know, yeah,
give out the deets.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
There you go.
Okay.
So we've got Medley P with us today, people.
Inside, MP, man.
Inside.
He's not an MP though. He's not a pagan politician. He tells the truth.
Tell the truth.
He says the things people are scared to say.
And that's what we're here for. The truth.
Nothing but the truth.
So we've got this polygraph that's just going to be wielded now. I'm going to ask you some very intimate questions.
Oh no.
About your habits and your lifestyle. And what you get up to when no one's watching?
We've had a secret agent.
You didn't tell him about this either.
Secret agent following you around for the past 3 weeks.
Oh no.
So,
shout out to Nigel.
Yeah, Nigel.
Great rates.
And
great
Judith.
Results.
Judith.
Yep, yep.
Oh,
she's
Judith.
Like a thief in the night, that lady.
My DJ deck is called Judith.
What, you've got a name for your decks?
Yeah, because the person you gave me is called Josie. She's a DJ from Bristol. Altac J-O-Z. Bad man. She's got an event on Saturday.
Get down there, put your dancing shoes on.
Yeah. So I was like, I gotta name my decks after her, so I was like, I'll call him Judith. Thought it'd be funny.
My name ain't Judith,
but I was like a different J. So I don't know. My mind thinks differently, I can't lie.
Yeah, if nothing, it's of respect for the original J who was spinning on there. So can't complain about that.
J onto the M.
E.
But just so you don't run out. We've not got a polygraph or anything like that.
Okay.
We're not going to grill you like that, but we're going to, you know, ask you a couple of questions because we're interested about you. We want to know what goes on in the head of Medley P.
Oh,
yeah.
There's a lot.
Okay.
There's a lot.
Okay. Shall we get things started?
Yeah. So,
come on, man.
Let's jump in.
So, Medley P, what was just, well, first of all, the background of yourself? So, we know you're a big grime head.
Yep, for sure.
Which is a... It's a genre, it's a nice genre, but we want to know how, why, where, when you was exposed to grime and your love for grime.
You know what, if we're going to talk about my love for grime, then we got to go back to my original love and still love, which is Garage.
Garage, okay.
So this is probably the funniest story I ever told, like anyone who knows me. So I remember the first time I heard Soul Solid Crew, 21 Seconds. And it was after I was at my family's yard in Scotland. Everyone's sort of gone to sleep. I don't know why I was up. And I think I had MTV on or something. South Park was on. I was like six, so I used to find South Park hilarious because I used to try and put it on TV all the time. I don't know why. 21 Second comes on and I was just infatuated. Like, it was that moment as a kid, you know, when you first listen to, like, people say the first time they heard the Beatles or something like that. That's what that moment was for me, because I was like, I heard, like, UK, like, bear in mind, I was probably like eight or something at the time. I'd sort of heard like US rappers. I knew them more than any sort of UK MCs. So when I heard that, I was like, oh, this is sick. So these men can actually do this. And I remember for ages, I used to go to my mate's yard Old Tat Josh Nice. I gave out the government's too easy, I know. Jeez. But I used to go to his yard and we used to play Yu-Gi-Oh as Utes, and I used to be like, he used to spin rhythms. So he put on like Soulja Boy. For some reason he had like a massive thing for Soulja Boy. And I was like, nah, have you heard this? And I played 21 seconds and we used to just go mad. We used to sort of do the bars about tobacco and everything. Yeah. And then when I got older, I had like a trip to, I'd just finished my GCSEs. And I knew about certain names in the sound, like Tiny Tempers, you know, the guy who was just doing the sort of pop sort of stuff. Yeah. So like Retro, when he was doing his pop stuff, example, Chip, sort of names like that. But I hadn't knew what the core of what grime was properly. So when I went on a trip, it was a drive around like Europe, my rents, I was like, I felt a little bit homesick. It was weird. Never felt like this ever. Cause I was like, oh, my mates are, you know when you have that, it's like year 11, you know what I mean? Boom, you've got a break now. You're gonna go to college or something. It's that spring essence of, you know, you wanna do something with your life. I don't know, link 10 girls at the same time, eat like 10 sausages.
Because your life's gonna change dramatically when you go back to normality.
Exactly.
So you wanna do something abnormal.
Exactly.
So I fail every weekend.
Yeah.
Trust me. So after, like on that trip, I just started listening to Old School Garage again. And then I had like a weird little app, like it was kind of like SoundCloud, but not SoundCloud. So you could download offline.
Tubidy.
Nah, bro, it wasn't even Tubidy, bro. It was
worse,
something
better.
Worse, bro. Like you
got
could,
the job done.
You could type a song in and it would come up with just SoundCloud listings. You could download it. So then I found like a lot of Skepta. So I was listening to, I think That's Not Me came out at that time. But then I went back in time. So I just started going for like Private Caller, Flipping. What's the tune with JME, him and Wiley? There's a tune called, obviously, like, Dead. I think the instrumental was Dead. It was on Lord of the Mics 2. I just went through the archives. So I started listening to Dizzy. Kano was a big one. JME, a lot of JME. Scorcher. And the Scorcher was a real big influence. I thought Scorcher was a bad man.
The way he could assert it back in the day. The movement was fucking levels ahead back then, I thought, as a collective. All on point. All barbers, pretty much. All barbers.
Bro, they were like the... They were flipping the Avengers of crime.
Yeah.
And when I got to college, I had a friend, you may know him as AO19, big up, obviously.
Yeah, you know who he is.
So I used to message him, and me and him were like, I used to tell, like, yo, do you know my man? So Frisco, and he used to send me tunes from Frisco, and I try and just ask him for bangers and shit all the time. And then at one stage he was like, I ain't got nothing else to show you, bro. So I just...
You tried me out. I've got nothing left.
Big up Ayo, yeah. I swear down, he'll remember that as well. But I just started searching for YouTube. I used to just go like, yo, what? I thought radio didn't exist, yo. I just thought radio and grime sets just didn't exist after some point. So I then went on YouTube one day and I found Sir Spyro for the first time. He had a set with Jams, Novelist, and Frisco. I remember it so vividly because I was at college, had a meal deal, I was on break, and I was like, fuck it. I started watching and I was like, this was so nang. So that's the first time I heard Novelist as well. And from there, it just spiraled into what the new scene was at the time. So Radar Radio, Big Zoo shows had a big influence on everything that I've sort of done for Gunfingers as well. Like, I remember the first time I heard all of them, man, like, AJ, Big Zoo, Mike Titan Jams, they were on an SBTV freestyle with like Logan for like Fabric, one of his albums he bought out, instrumental thing. Pardon me. And I was like, yo, these men are going to be like, you know, you get the four kings in boxing. I was like, them men are going to be the four kings of grime. And from there, like, that's why there's another artist who's had like a big impact on me. It's probably AJ Tracy.
Yeah.
I thought the way that he, the first time I heard Spirit Bomb, I'd never really. I think you know when you don't know a genre, like trap for example, You didn't know what it was called. Like I probably heard him first, and when he heard Spirit Bomb, or I probably have heard something before that. Like I was a big ASAP Rocky fan, so Something there. But him, Big Sue, Mike Towers, Cole, Jams. There was the whole Radar Radio era, where like a lot of today's radio. If you look at BBC One Extra for example, Snooty Shy, Kenny All Star. Big Sue has a residency on there. Bro, the BBC must have been so happy when Radar got shut down because they got a whole heap of talent roll through.
Serious.
It was a big CV built for a lot of people. So like, as much as there were bad problems there, like, I do think it was a hub for a lot of scenes.
Talent come through, really.
But as you can see, whatever bad, you know, bad energy, bad whatever was going on there, it wasn't exclusive to the people who were doing the shows and stuff. Or it wasn't them, do you get me? They were just honest people who loved their trade and were trying to apply it in a place where they could. And then if you're doing that passionately, it's going to end up coming good in some degree later on down the line, isn't it? 100%. You know what I mean? You might be without a show for a week, 2 weeks, a month. Then you end up doubling up and you want one extra. You know what I mean? So
literally, man.
It's worthwhile. It's worthwhile.
But I'd say that's my origin. And a lot of... The one thing for me is, especially anyone who's like into music, you know, you have them hours where you're like, you're going through YouTube or something, or you're finding sets or like instrumentals. Like, I've got a playlist where I've just... on YouTube, where I've just banged all my fit, like instrumentals that I found and liked through subscribing to certain YouTube channels or whatnot, they're all on my playlist. And then a lot of them that I've used to then find the beat, put it on Gunfingers for freestyles and whatnot. So it's been like a big thing like that. Like when I look through that, I look at certain instrumentals and I go, oh, I remember this then when I was, another day I was at home or something, like random searching for something, or certain tunes, I've got memories in certain tunes, don't you get me?
Yeah. So it's all about it's just capturing the time, innit? The song is capturing the time that they made it, and then when you first hear it.
So if you go on your Insta, like for me, for example, I use Instagram saved a lot. So like a lot of like crep, like I'm a huge Trainer fanatic. You get me, 97. Sure.
Golden.
My best shoes on. Yeah. Not my best shoes.
But you didn't want to get called out,
Oh, yo.
The dunk thing.
Had to bring them out. Got called out last time, didn't I?
Brand coordination.
Exactly.
But like, back to what I was saying, like I looked through that and I remember, I think I've got a good memory. I probably have a better memory than a lot of people, but
yeah,
like,
I
look
better
through,
than me anyway.
I'll look through something and I'll be like, I remember when I saved that and why I was looking at it.
Yeah,
it goes to the same thing.
So it's not wasted. Yeah, because you might end up just taking it out. Like, I had no purpose for that. I was just high or fucking
something like something like
or
that.
Or just distracted or something.
Yeah, like a funny meme or something. I'm supposed to lend it to someone. But yeah, that's my origin story really, and I think that's the best way to say it, bro. I just started exploring, and then from there, when I decided to go university, I was doing games development at college at Derby Joseph Wright. And I was like, I don't really... Afterwards, I was like, you know what? Well and truly, yeah, I didn't realise what would come with a course like that. You've got to do the graphics. You've got to do this. I like designing the concept of a story. Because I used to draw manga and, like, comics. Like, manga especially, because I'm a big anime and manga guy. But I was like, that's what I liked about it. Like, creating a story and a concept and characters. But I didn't like the coding and all this other stuff. And then I looked at it truthfully and I was like, there's no girls on this course. And I was like, I don't think there ever will be. Actually, that's probably a strong comment. That was a really strong comment.
What the views of Gunfingers are of his own and not of the local Geezers Corporation. Just got to say that, folks. Yeah. Okay.
At the same time, for me personally,
disclaimer.
It has to be a disclaimer. Like, I'm not budging anyone or anything. There's beautiful women out there, regardless of who you are. But personally, I was at a stage where I was just like, I need to do something where I can. There's the right more. Mortality people in general. So I went and I used to like doing media production when I was in GCSE years. So I was like, F it, I'll do that again. And I was like, yo, I had this love for grime and whatnot at the time. And I was like, radio was the big thing. And people have always sort of said to me, this is something that sound cocky, like, oh, you could be a comedian or you could be like, you could do radio. You've got kind of a voice for it.
Yeah.
A personality, innit?
All it takes is a personality and being willing to.
Exactly, a lot of willingness.
Yeah.
So I was like, you know what? I made it my goal that I was going to go to university, do media production. I originally wanted to do radio production, but I realised if I did media production, I'd get at the broad escape of doing digital design. So I know how to do like EP covers and stuff like that. Or doing radio where I'm getting the core skills, and then television production so I can fuck about and make music videos. I've realised. Can you swear on this or not?
No, you can swear, okay. You can do anything.
Phew. I've sort of asked this before, but
it's
okay,
it's fine.
I forget sometimes myself, like, can we call it? Fuck it.
But yeah, I got an overall skill set. So when it came to certain things I've worked on in the future, I've been able to pull out skills from the back, which a lot of other men couldn't be able to do.
Yeah.
In like a kind of a basic form to some extent, but now I'm doing it a lot more. So for example, visuals, like recording studio sessions and stuff like that, or radio where I've got to have a mic level at a certain place, or digital design where I've got to change, I don't know, the DPI of a photo. I've got like a mixed bag of skills. Yeah. And that's what it came from. And I spent like the first 2 years at uni really messing about. I just wanted to get waved constantly. I don't know, I turned 18 and I was like, all I wanted to do was just go out.
Mm-hmm.
And I had like a good set of people. Like, I'd not really in my life, there's a lot of people, if you know me, know for a fact that I'm not the best with certain people. So if I know my energy's off, then I'm not there. I like, and I've had a lot of bad friendships where the idea and concept of trust was like, it left me for quite a long time.
Yeah.
And people who know me now in college and whatnot sort of saw a progression as me as a person. So if I'd never really given that up, I would probably not be in the situation where I am right now. But it took a lot for me to do that because I've just seen how certain things worked and certain relationships between certain people just turned my heart a little bit cold, innit?
Sometimes you have to go through that though, don't you? Like,
yeah.
I don't regret it.
No, you shouldn't. Because you've found the balance now. It's like, yeah, you might go to a point where you're completely closed off and very cold, but then eventually you start to... You're still wary of people, but you start to let people in, but in a safer sort of way.
You know,
yeah.
like
you don't go gung-ho and like, hey, I'll lend you 20 quid or, oh, I'll do whatever for you.
Exactly.
No, you ain't earned that from me yet, because I know I'm a good person.
Yeah.
So why am I giving you my all at that? I'll give you what's appropriate, but then when I know your gang, then
you get gang treatment. Yeah, definitely. That's for a lot of things, especially with me and my mates. Like, I've had certain mates, it's quite funny, like even recently, my mate's seeing a bird and she's turned around to him like, why is he so cold?
As in you?
Me. And I was like, out of most people, like, I don't know. You know what I mean? You give the right energy at a certain time. And she was like, oh, I thought you didn't like me at first. She told me this while she was very drunk. And I thought it was hilarious because I wasn't waved at all.
Yeah.
But
it's when the truth comes out.
Yeah, exactly. And I was like, nah, I never thought of that. I just didn't, like, you get me? It just takes a little bit longer with me to... with certain people. Like,
some people force convo as well, that's what you got to remember. Some people force conversation. It's like, they find, like, you know, if we would sit, we can't now because we're recording, but if we're going to just sit for 10 seconds in silence, it wouldn't be a drama.
Yeah.
Some people, they'd be like,
got to fill the gap.
Coronavirus, what about it?
That's me.
Or, yeah, it's all summer.
That's me.
Do you know what I mean? Just anything to fill the gap, like, you don't need to do that. Just like,
yo, that new D-Block Europe, man. Oh gosh, something like that.
Yeah, you know. Yeah. Should we put it on now as well?
But yeah, that's probably your best way to say my origin story, really. I mean, there's a lot more I could talk about, but I know you might have got questions. So
yeah, save that for your best-selling book. The All Talent.
Yeah. All Talent. Autobiography.
A medley of memories.
A medley of memories.
Boy,
I read that name a lot.
He's got way with words. Yeah.
I'm telling you, mate. I can package your product, give it a sexy name.
Who gave us the name for the project?
Told me this. Whiz.
Tell him, lads.
Mad. Yeah, no, I think I'm kind of similar. Because what I used to do is, like, I think I've still got this on my old phone. So I took Instagram very seriously at one point. I don't know why.
When I say serious,
I used to have a quotes page in my notes. So I used to put random things down. So I found this the other day on my emails. And I genuinely looked at it and I was like, if I said any of this stuff in public, people will either think I am a rapper or I'm not a rapper. I used to put, like, one of the ones I saw the other day was Night Tick selling bricks. I was like, I'm not selling bricks though, so why have I written this down? Do you know what I mean?
Wait, so where are you picking these quotes up? Or is this what you wrote?
This is what I wrote down. Oh. So I used to like, I still do it a little bit, and I don't tell a lot of people unless they see me once I'm quite drunk. Like, I bar a little bit, but I just keep it on my phone. So yeah. I've got a load of notes pages where I've just made stuff, because I just listened to Bear MCs and I was like, yo, might I can do well. Something like this, yeah, I'll just keep it to my ones.
Yeah, of course.
So then I like the idea of, like, I rate when I see a track listing for an album and I see a word that's different. Or, like, I'm trying to think of a really good example. Bro, your EP is a good example. Cognac Arcade. Mm. I was like, Cognac and Arcade. How does this work? But it works. You get me? So I rate when I see things like that. So
it's just meaning. It's just attaching meanings and then also finding me. Like, when we was talking about it, it was... What is the tape?
Yeah.
A fun tape.
Yeah, we're brainstorming it.
And then, so what is a fun place? An arcade.
Yeah.
What do you love?
what brandy, creates fun.
But brandy arcade sounds cheap.
Cognac's
got that classiness to it.
We got my cognac sippers, man.
And it's the attention to detail.
Luxury.
About that, to be fair.
Before, actually, last thing. Last thing I want to say, bro. Yeah. Wasted in Barcelona. I have been wasted in Barcelona. And isn't that track gave me that vibe. Like, I was back there 2017, bro. One of the best trips I've had in my life has been to Barcelona.
I can't wait for the stag,
man. We're going there.
I've been on a more low-key one.
We're going there June. For a stag do.
You know what? If I do... Oh, wait. It's a stag do, I can't just roll.
Well, you could get a flight at the same time and just miraculously bump into us in random places.
Every now and again.
Sorry, guys.
We're here. Oh, fancy seeing you here.
Nah, I couldn't do that.
Why not?
Nah, it's a bit weird.
Book your flight.
I mean, unless you invite me, innit?
Well, it's not my stag.
Exactly, so I'm not doing that, bro. I have actually been in a stag do in Barcelona. I went to Barcelona originally for a university, and my cousin flew out for his wedding. Or his stag do, really.
So you was at university in Barcelona? You went on a trip with university?
Trip with university.
Oh, okay.
So they got like, bro, we stayed on a hostel. It was far from a hotel. It was a hostel.
But did they say it was going to be a hotel?
Nah, bro. I swear to gosh, you walk in this place, it looks like you're in Call of Duty Zombies.
Rusty bunk beds.
Bro, yeah, all of that.
It's in a good location.
All of that.
It's in a good location. Last Ramblers.
Oh, true, bro. When you got out, you literally had Mackey's, KFC.
You're on a strip.
And at night time, a lot of prostitutes and coffee shops.
Well, I mean, what more do you need?
You take it as you imagine that to be. I'm not going to say the true gritty
facts. We'll say no. We'll leave that one for you people in the audience to ponder and see where your thoughts go to. And anyway, so moving on. So you told us that at this point, you're doing your course, you're dibbling and you're dabbling in the little bits and bobs of creating content and stuff like that. So from that point, where did the podcast or the interviews, whatever kind of phrase that you want to come, you know, the Gunfinger shows that we've done, he's done, etc. What was the motivation behind that? How did that happen?
So the main thing that started off Gunfingers for me was like I got to the end of my second year, and I was like, I kind of forgot why I did my course.
Yeah.
I was like, the end of frame of my course, by the way, was to either be at the end of it in a position where I'm on the right tracks towards 1XTRA and Asian Network. So I was like, I want to make a portfolio for myself. I'd started listening to sort of podcasts around that time. I think Gasworks isn't a podcast, but as a show, and Halfcast podcast especially, I used to find that really there's a lot of it now. Like, I'll still watch some of them, but the ones where they had like Savage Dan and they were going to like Thailand and talking about how
mad stories. That one's joke still.
You know what you're on about. So I kind of was there like, you know what, if I could pattern this together as like, because I call it a podcast, but it's kind of like a podcast with a layout. So it's got an intro, I do all my questions, and then I have like a couple of segments where I talk about trainers, for example, you know, new music that's coming out. Like, we talked about flipping Visual Flavors, like Conductor's music, but I was talking about trainers and TNs and whatnot. We had a little freestyle segment at the end. That was my idea. So that's the way I could give it to my uni, because it was a course thing that I originally started it off for. And then I realized, even my lecturer was like, yo, this is actually quite sick. Like, he didn't really understand grime or rap to say in general, but he was like, this is a concept that's working because it follows the guidelines, but it's also a bit of me. That's what I realized. I was like, I wasn't doing anything that was sort of I liked, to say the least. I did a documentary in my second year about flipping. Okay, probably not flipping is the right word to say, but my cousin's kid, Karim, the breakdancer. So my lecturer sort of said, you should go for that idea. And don't get me wrong, I think it was sick. I got to go to an event and whatnot and film it. But then I was really there, like, yeah, hip hop and whatnot. Yeah, that's my thing. But I was like, I don't know. I thought breakdancing was kind of cool, but it wasn't like my sort of thing. Wasn't my sort of thing in general. But yeah, so I thought about that back then. I was like, why don't I do like something about trainers or GAMS? Because all I used to do at university, I used to get a break and be on JD or Foot Locker or Kicks on Fire and just look at Crips.
Sometimes you think like that those kind of things are too simplistic or Do you know what I mean? They won't get the reaction that you think they could, that other things could get.
Yeah.
But it all boils down to like what you put into it. Like if you're passionate about it again, and if you plan it out well, you execute it well, you can make an interesting topic on, or a piece of content on anything.
On anything, yeah.
As long as it's yeah. executed right, and there's a bit of structure and a bit of thought, you can make it happen. Do you get what I'm saying? But it sometimes takes you a long time to realise that.
100%.
So then you stick to the safer, maybe not as invested in options.
That's the thing, like, I turned around and I was like, I want to make a living out of this, so why am I not doing something that I'd be happy about making a living for? Because that's what I liked about media. I was like, man, I'm turning around and making movies. People are making music. There's a different, do you know what I mean? There's a formula to this which works for the modern day, where I think that's what's so nang about it. And with Gunfingers as well, by the way, that got me my first ever first in anything I've done at university.
Sick.
And I won an award at my last, so they're all like a yearly awards thing, so for each year they'll do one. So the last 2 years I used to be kind of like vexed that I didn't really get an award, but I thought about it and I was like, I didn't really do anything that made me probably would have given me an award. So when I did that year, I got like most hard work improved student. I was like, yo, they actually did care, and it was all because of what I'd done with Gunfingers. And it was mad. I did if anyone was there, I'll type my guys from here, Free Media Production 2019 graduates. They knew the speech that I did where I had a little. Has anyone seen Mostak's Daily Doppy? The latest one.
Mm-mm.
Basically, he has a whole segment. He has like, I shit you not, a good 30 seconds to like a minute where he shouts at every guy who's in jail that's his boy. I had one of them moments for everyone who'd done something for Gunfingers.
Sick.
And then I said, suck your mum at the end of it and walked off stage with my award.
Jeez, that's hard.
I was quite waved at the time as well, so
you got footage of that?
Yeah, I'll show you that afterwards, bro.
Sick.
Yeah,
sick.
Trust me.
Was that well received?
It wasn't, to be honest.
Even by like this other students must have been like,
your people must have been like, bruh.
There were a couple people that understood it. But your media production, there's like certain man who get why I'd like what I like. So you know, you could play drill with them or whatnot. There's a couple of indie youths and whatnot, you get me? There's a mixed bag in it. There's a mixed bag of people. Some people didn't really understand, but certain people did. Like, my boys were so gassed when they got that award. Because they didn't know what, like, of my other two mates sort of got nominated for stuff, but I was only one in the end of the day. And they were like, yo, man, we'll pour up properly. You get me?
Definitely.
That was a good night.
Properly, man. Pop, baby.
You get me?
Properly.
So, yeah, Gunfingers did a lot for me on that level. And also, it comes back to what I was saying about podcasts. I just liked interviewing in general. So it came off just doing that, and I wanted to get involved with the local scene and really do something where it hadn't been shed a light on before. That's what I thought I was, to some extent, like a platform where people, as an artist, you know, you can listen to an artist all you want, but for example, one person I'm really feeling right now, Lil TJ, like if there was a podcast, if something he'd been talking about with Big Boy or something like an interview, I'd watch it. You want to know more about the person.
Yeah.
Getz is one of those people for me as well. Like I could read this part. I've watched podcasts with Getz and I've reloaded certain bits because they're just that sick what he's saying. So yeah, man, I think that's where it's truthfully came from. That's the main idea.
Yeah. Lovely.
So where do you see it going then with the podcast in general, like?
My podcast series in general, for me, the next thing I really want to do is, I actually want to move away from the podcast form. I actually want to make it more like radio. And I've not really talked to a lot of people about this, but I want to give it a sort of essence that Derby, obviously you guys are a really good example. Fam, you're doing Chinwag, you get me, on Kiki. Big ups for that, because they're doing bits as well right now. So it's a good platform to definitely be on. But I was like, because I want to be within the radio industry, I could still do my podcast, but I want to do like pre-record radio, have MCs in, because I've got connections now. This is the thing, like I've been going to events where I've probably not had enough money to get it to go to in general, or I've been in certain places at the right time and I've made connections with certain MCs or certain DJs or certain promoters. And to be honest, I ain't done that because I just want to make, I want to make my links and better and make my own flipping empire. Like, I get along, like, I've got along with them sort of people because they see my vision and they've seen what I've done as well.
Yeah.
So it's easy when the energy works, similar how we met. So my thing was just, I want to go into that realm so I'm more prepared for that area when I do get there, because I do want to be a presenter one day and do like my own radio sets and whatnot. So that's probably the main thing I want to do for the future. I still want to keep the podcasts going, but I feel radio would be a sick look.
So what's your dream job?
My dream job?
A dream placement or dream show?
It'd have to be, personally, the first one that I said, really, it'd be Radio 1 Extra. But to be honest, if I was on any London station, yeah, because I think that in itself is a blessing. 1 Extra is definitely a big one, because I'd want them to have a show where... I always said I wanted to have, like, an underdog sort of show. I wanted to show the undertones between what grime can be or what drill can be, for example. Like, the different areas that not a lot of people shine light on. So that's my main sort of thing, I'd say. If I was anything, a presenter... I'd say a presenter, a DJ, if I was spinning in clubs, like, across the country. Not even clubs, you know. Like, raves, bro. I like the nitty... You know, nitty-gritty rave, you know?
Yeah.
So, like, that's me. Yeah. I don't go to Moo Moo's and expect to hear... Scream. The old type, my guys scream, night dub plates and stuff.
The underground,
low-key team.
You get me?
Basement business.
My mate pars me.
Warehouse batch.
Warehouse mezzanine and that.
You get me? You get me? You know, when you see someone with the arms in the air, they're here for the right type of music, sort of thing.
Yeah.
You get me?
Yeah, 100%.
I don't expect to pop up in the basement and, like, Maya Mills is playing or something. Like.
Maya Mills, you know? Maya Mills.
We've been talking a lot about... You know what? We'll get into that.
We'll get Maya Mills count.
We'll get into that later. But, that will probably be it, you know? DJing across these, like, Nilo Graves. Graves, raves, producing. I want to learn how to produce.
Crowd's dead, man. No noise.
That's Graves. I'd say producing is one thing I really want to get into.
That's the next topic. Yeah. So, obviously, you sent us over some bits. We're gonna play a little summit after this segment. But yeah, with your producing and stuff like that, like, we just spoke off air about what you kind of call it. And things like that, but just want to know kind of like where the direction is going with that.
So the direction with that right now, I'd say, is truthfully, it's more fun for me right now. It's not something like, I don't know if I would ever get to a stage where I'm putting them on, like, I'm probably going to, the release for this EP will probably be on Bandcamp.
Okay.
And it's going to be a free thing, because for me, I made these tunes for the joy of myself and the fact that I could be in my room and I'm mixing. And I'm like, oh, that's sick. And I've made this myself. So what I actually do, for the people at home wondering what you mean by production, I call it dissecting, because I've got acapellas, so I've got access to certain acapellas, grime ones, and I want to get access to other types of acapellas in the future and basically get instrumentals that I like, that I think would work well with a tune, and put them in together. So I've made a pack. I'm gonna call it. I was originally gonna call it the Jeep Pack. Don't ask why, but now it's being called the Maya Mills Pack.
M's up.
You get me.
The Maya Mills Pack. You heard it here first. So what is an EP?
It's gonna be a little EP of edits that I've bought.
Is that
out.
First
release for me.
That means, is that like putting it out there, like?
Oh yeah, yeah, that's
the
first.
An EP.
Yeah, that's the first.
That's an exclusive here at Trinwag.
You get me.
Fair. So that's good, man.
I wanted to do it because I feel, especially, I've got enough respect for people who put out free download as well. If they're up and coming and whatnot, and they've got hard stuff, there's a lot of stuff that goes under the rails where it's like they haven't seen that. And a lot of my collection as well has been a mixture of free download and stuff that I paid for certain MCs or producers. So I've got to big them up. And
mm-hmm.
I think this is another first. I was going to say, this is another first for the radio show. I want to do, like, because I'm planning on doing it as a monthly thing, I want to do, I want to call it, it's called 0% Commission, where I'm just going to do, like, a 15-minute or 20-minute mix just full of tunes that are free, and I have a track listing so people can get them, because I think if I can do that as a platform and build my thing up for what I'm doing, certain producers turn around and be like, oh, right, my man's, yo, this beat is cold, where do I get that? Do you know what I mean? Just making connections.
Yeah.
Makes connections. And I hadn't seen anyone really do that. Apart from Once Upon a Grime, they're like a blog, and they do a thing called, I think it's free donations. So they do, it's either like a monthly thing where they go through the latest free downloads that came out for Grime. So that's one of the things I want to do. But yeah, I think in general, my idea behind it is just the fact that I've had fun with making these little dissections. Mm. I want to put them in a pack, and then people can have them to, you know, spin at rave and everyone goes mad. It's like that whole, it's like how Dizzy used to, how Dizzy started in grime. He was like, he used to write bars for a reaction, you get me?
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to go radio or something, and people be like, oh, you said that, how you do that? Or not even just for the, kind of not just for the reload, but I just think when I, some of the stuff that I've made, especially for this, from how I've cut certain parts of the acapella to the instrumental, it's just Nang. And I just want people to see, whether they take a care or attention or not. Similar to how JME, even with JME's last album, bro, he didn't even want to release that. He just did everything that he did because he liked the music. It was for him. And it's similar for me, but I'm like, yo, if you rate it, you rate it. If not, it don't matter to me.
That's how it should always be. Should always be like
exactly.
That.
Should like, you can't force it.
I'm going to turn around and like make a label or something one day, or I am working with a label right now, but that's not anything to do with my music side of things. But big up Scene Not Heard. Big up Scene Not Heard, 100%.
Any other big ups you want
to? Oh, any other big ups? Big up Gunfingers. Big up Local Geezers, bro. You lot were an inspiration for me making my podcast.
Thank you, bro.
Genuinely, when I was listening back, I have enough joke. The Christmas, was it the Christmas update episode?
Oh, yeah,
when
Christmas.
When your mum were like a hotel or something, you're like, yo, the plug's gonna like fire.
Oh, yeah, that was
really? Oh, yeah.
That was a little
that gave me too much joke, man.
There's a mad story about that. That hostel there that we stayed in. It wasn't a hostel, was it?
Oh, something like that.
Nah, not something like that. That was a different
one. Was it not something like that?
It was a Somalian brother.
Oh, yeah, we nearly got jacked up by a Somalian brother. He followed us in.
Yeah, he followed us
Followed us in all the way up to the top. I'm going to put the key in the door, and them men are like, yo, he's still behind us, you know? So then we was just like, oh, I think we left some stuff at...
Outside.
Let's just go back out.
And then everyone just turned around and marched back downstairs. And
we was going to be sleeping outside Tesco, but... Yeah, anyway, he disappeared, hadn't he? So all's well that ended well.
I think
but
he had a gun on him.
Maybe. Gun in fingers. Your arch nemesis. What I wanted to ask you, in terms of the dissection, so what's your creative approach to them? Like, do you just sift through acapellas? Do you sort out an acapella after you've heard a certain tune? Or do you hear a, like you might hear an old school R&B song and then you're like, oh, I want to turn that into some, like, what's your thought process?
My main thing, what I first do is, so I've got DJ Pro, Pro 2. I need to get Serato or something soon, man. I need to get into the big boy things, but it's helped me out because I can go on Spotify, for example, and like search for certain tunes. But I'll have my pack of acapellas that I've got, and I've just got, at this stage, so many instrumentals from grime in general or garage. And what I'll do is I'll just start flicking through them. So if I've got an idea in my head, so for example, one of the ones that we're going to be playing today, I mean, if you want to, I'll reveal it later, I don't know.
Reveal it now if you want, whatever.
Okay.
Yeah, whatever.
So the one that we're going to be playing is Medley P, Excuse the Originator. No, wait, Excuse Me Originator, not Excuse the Originator. And what I've done is, I thought about it and I was like, you don't hear P Money on R&B rhythms, obviously, because he beat the shit out of them.
Yeah.
And I was like, you know what? Let's recreate that. What would happen? So big up my guy Gundam from Bristol, I believe. He's a sick producer. He released a pack of instrumentals and refixes, basically. Mm-hmm. So refixes and grime is that if you've got like a flipping R&B tune and you just put loads of chops in it, for example.
Bring it up to 140.
Yeah, basically. Yeah. Bring it up to 140. Yeah. So yeah. And it's just four easily. I think they're like 20 by 20 packs. Per Gundam, 1 to 4. And I went through and I found a Chris Brown, obviously Excuse Me Miss by Chris Brown, done on a 140 format, and I placed it over it in DJ Pro 2, and I was like, when it starts, I was like, oh, it's mad, don't know what it is, but the feeling's mad. I was like, yo, this works so sick. And even what P Money's talking about in the tune, about girls asking about grime and whatnot, is similar to the approach within the Chris Brown video, where he's like, excuse me, miss, I seen you from across. You know what I mean? Yeah, it kind of played out in its own sort of UK sort of feel.
Mm-hmm.
So I then put it into, I don't even use like proper production programs. I use like Adobe Audition. I put it in there and I just started messing about with it. And it was so sick. I was like, yo, this is Nank. I played it to certain DJs and they were like, They were like, yo, how did you think of this? And I was like, bro, it's just the power's worked, you get me? And I think always people have said to me certain things. My close mates will say it to me, like, sometimes I just have mad thoughts on, like, a lot of random things. So if someone says something to me first, I'll say something completely out of the box. Uh-huh. For example, something we said off cam, which I'm not going to say on here.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. You know what?
I know what you're saying.
That's what I'm like in general. So I think that also adds to the production. So I've done other tunes that you'll see on the EP where I thought, yo, what would a certain MC sound like on a dubstep one, a dub 140 track?
Mm-hmm.
Stuff like that. It's always stuff that flows in my head. So first I'm mixing and then I'll put it into the main, lock it in. How do I want it to sound? Change, yo, put a limiter maybe here. Probably that's the least thing I'll do right now.
Yeah.
Because when I send them, when I started originally making tracks because I'm doing podcasts, I used to put them to the sound wave of a podcast. And I realised when I'm playing them, I'm mixing, they're mad quiet. So I was like, for this one, for these ones, I've had to boost them and whatnot as well. But yeah, that's probably one of the first things I learned. Boosting in general, like, it has to be loud.
Levels are important.
100%.
Levels of the bass. If your levels aren't right,
exactly,
you get egg on your face later.
Exactly.
You are.
So, I've even forgotten the question you asked me originally, to be honest.
It was about your process. Okay, you explained it, didn't you? You told us what the process was for Excuse Me Originator.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So you've told us that, and I guess at the moment you're still kind of finding your...
Still finding
your
my
real creative flow for that. You know what I mean? Like you say, you might want to... Because DJ Pro, does that have decks, or is it like a virtual DJ thing?
So it's a virtual DJ, but I've got my own decks as well.
And
so
you can plug them into it?
Yeah, I've plugged them in.
Oh, pattern.
So I plug them in and I'm mixing.
Yeah.
Another first I'm going to say on here is I am going to be releasing a mix soon. I'm going to make it a monthly mix called Mind of Medley, where I just basically play stuff that I rate. And if you like it, you like it, you get me? I'm just trying to get there out there as a mixer. And then I'm going to start moving into more radio realms, start doing sets and stuff like that. That's the goal, really, because my dad was a DJ.
Okay.
DJ back in the day, used to DJ the hotel that my family owned in Scotland. And he was a massive hip-hop fan as well. So it sort of stemmed from that, but also like other family members. I've got family in Dartford. He used to tell me he was a DJ. What was it? Was it Magic FM? He didn't say it. No, not Magic. What's it called? It's gonna really spin my mind. I think he was on some Next Pirate radio station in like East London, and he was the selector. So mum was on the phone saying, "Yo, big up Becky. She's having a nice night with the girls tonight," or something.
That's
so hard. I think it's sort of always been there to some extent. But I was like, this is what I rate. I rate the gritty stuff.
Mm.
And I was like, I just want to do so. Like the same way that this whole the Maya Mills pack came out. This came from literally just me, just liking how certain things sound and wondering how they sound together. So that's what I do. Like one thing, for example, if you ever see me on a live set, which will be some point within the distant, not distant future,
near
is
future,
mixing Cassie Kiss Me into dubstep tracks.
Fucking hell.
Like, not when I say dubstep, I mean like UK dubstep, like Mala and DMZ, like the old school sort of stuff. And there's some new guys, there are people like Kane and Neek who are doing stuff right now who I've got enough love for. And Koki's still doing bits. I think even Darksy's going back to his dubstep roms because he's got his own label out now, Grottingham or something.
Yeah.
So I think that's pretty cool, like mixing R&B, drill. Drill and dub work so well together. I feel like I'm giving too many gems for the people then, but yo, you're going to see a dub and drill mix from me soon because those genres just work so well. Like, it's insane. Like, I've seen certain DJs doing it, and big up Hayes from Leeds, because I saw him on a set and he mixed in, like, it might have been a Deep Medi release with Digga D, No Man. Diet. And I was like, yo, this is Nan.
Mm.
I was like, I want to explore this realm a bit and see what's cracking.
Yeah, for sure.
Wave, whoa.
A lot on the horizon, isn't it?
Medley P, it's been a pleasure, brother.
As always, man. I didn't even get to say half the stuff that I wanted to talk about. But
we've got one more question, haven't we, as well? We've got one more question.
Go for it.
Because, you know, you're a young lad, but you got your head screwed on.
Thanks.
It's like you're going in the right direction.
Mm-hmm.
So for the people below us, below you, not in terms of, like, worth or anything like that.
Again, just meaning, disclaimer for Wiz. It's nothing to do with JDK.
Nothing to do with me.
Nothing to do with me either. But what I mean is, for the people who are just starting their journeys, what advice would you have for them to help them get to where they want to get to? Because it seems like you're on your journey, but you've probably already got to some places you wanted to get to. And there's a couple more that you need to get to, but you have a plan of how to get there.
Yeah, it's quite clear in your head by the sound.
So what would you, what gems would you give them?
Boy, I was thinking about this question because certain people do ask me.
Mm.
You know what? And I think it's a mentality thing as well.
Yep.
Is, this is why I rate you guys so much. I meet so many artists who say certain things like, oh yeah, I've got this EP coming out next week. Nothing comes out. Or they say they're releasing a single, but they ain't. Or they ain't made a music video for it, or they've not done a flipping, even like, yo, getting it onto Spotify. Yeah. Like, there's a lot of man who think there's just, like, even, just, I know I'm talking about music here. It's consistency and really being on the ball. And you can't, like, have the mentality of, like, oh, yeah, like, I know I've got work tomorrow, for example, or I know I've got something to do. I'll just get blazed and fucked tonight and then try and hope that I'll, even though you know you won't be all right, and then screw up an opportunity. Always being prepared. And I think one of the best things that you can do if you want to get into the field like media, bro, if there's a BBC put an event like music introducing, for example, or there's a workshop going down in a certain place, travel to it, get the connections, go back to the safe house, bro. That's the best thing I can say. And if anyone does want to get in touch with me with anything that they are doing and I can help out in any way that I can, then my Instagram is P8OLA. And
P8OLA.
Yeah. People always get confused by that.
I was confused for 2 years.
2 years, yeah. Nah.
P8OLA.
But it's literally just my government, isn't it? So, you know, P-Bola. But the 8 is instead of a B. So swag. Yeah, anything that's
revolutionary.
Like, swag. When I realised, I thought it makes sense.
I can't believe that long. That needs to be your number plate when you're older.
Swear.
If you don't have that number plate, either that, well, you're gonna have probably two cars because you'll be a successful like presenter in that. So the range might have
E30
the PA Ola on that, yeah. And then we need like a Gunfingers one as well.
Yo, you know, I will, you know.
And a medley one as well.
A medley.
Oh yeah, and a medley one. Yeah.
A medley, Gunfingers.
PA Ola.
M3D13Y.
Yeah. Space
pattern off, pattern off.
Trust me. Yeah, man. Definitely, like, it's got to be consistency because I see too many dons who get into this thing and think they're going to half-ass it.
Yeah.
And I know, for example, like, you guys, even when it came to, like, this radio show, you know, you make music, you've got jobs and whatnot, you're diver at university, you know, it's hard to fit everything into the gaps, but I think Lordy said it on Gasworks once, there's always a way around everything that you're doing.
Mm.
Like, you have to find that way. Car, you just, in this industry like this, you know, it can be very cutthroat.
Yeah.
And you just got to really be on the ball. But also, like, I think one of the best things you can be, and I've learned it in certain situations, boy, I've learned it in certain situations, is be humble. And if you do, say, for example, meet the best thing that I've, oh man, if you meet like someone who's within that industry for the first time and that, you know, just be a person first. Realness gets so far. Don't turn around and tell me you're fine at D-Block Europe and then spit on their shoes or something when you see them. Or, I don't know, like, just be real, innit? Just be real for what you are. Like, if you know you don't like something, just
don't, like, be afraid to put your opinion across. Don't people please, because then you get unstuck in other situations because you forgot you said this while you was with this person. Like, hey, wait a minute.
Yeah.
You said you don't like them.
Exactly. So,
caught out.
Shit, you get caught out. Trust me, B. I've seen this stuff happen.
I've been caught out.
Man, I get caught out. And, yo, it's realness, consistency. Yeah. And also being humble. Car. Yeah. I think that's the best things that I can really say.
Yeah.
It's
good advice still.
Are you the type of guy as well? So you said you'll go to the event, you'll come back, whatever. Like, if it's a last ditch thing where you only find out about it the night before or in the morning, are you going to make it happen? Or do you prefer to be in a situation where I know about it in advance?
I think, yeah. So for the best, more time, for example, something that really worked worked well for me, big up Eyes, I went down to his lock-off show. I was doing a work experience for a week. Mm. At Represent Radio, right, which was in Brixton. So I was staying with my family in, I'm not going to say where, obviously the ops, them are lurking, innit?
We'll put the postcode up after.
But, you know, I went down, so I finished work at probably like 5 or something.
Yeah.
Chilled out for a bit, went down to Peckham where it was. You get me, little stuff like that. So when you're down in a certain place, for example, you know, if you're, say, in London or, I don't know, if you're in Birmingham for the day or something, bro, go out and make these connections. Mm. When I went to that show, I met a lot of MCs and stuff where they turned around and knew who I was before they knew me.
Yeah.
Certain man were. And I was just making connections the whole time. Even, I got a big up Dubsy, actually, because I'd never met Dubsy before. But when he saw, I think he followed me on Twitter or he followed me on Instagram or something. He saw what I was doing, but he was always like, he saw me, he was like, yo, you're the only guy from Dubs who's doing bits like in this field for what you're doing. And like a lot of support. So I'd never really, I said to him, I was like, you know, a lot of people who I've met have not really turned around, never like said something like that. So I was really grateful, you get me. So when you get moments like that, it shows that you're on the right track.
Yeah, 100%. He notices a lot. You know, he notices a lot. He's observant.
Definitely, bro.
And it's good. Like I say, it's good when you get that recognition from somebody from your city.
100%.
Seeing what you're doing outside of your city, there's nothing better than that. Like, there is ultimately, but it's a great feeling. Do you know
what
I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's definitely a really good feeling. Yeah.
But I say being also working within your means, because in more time, you know, you can't go to everything.
Mm.
Say for example, like a great example would be like this weekend. I haven't currently got enough money to go down for Josie, like JOZ's rave that she's doing with Keep Hush. She's doing a full on grime set. It's going to be Nang. But if I had pre-planned how I was doing this, I probably could have been in a situation once, but I've been jobless and whatnot for a little while, and that's changed very recently. Pat, so I'm probably in a better situation now than I have been like the last couple of months. Like there is times where you've got to like, if you do have supportive people around you, if you've got supportive people like your parents and whatnot, thank them a lot, because trust me, my parents have bossed me in certain situations to get to certain places when they could have probably turned around and been like, this is my own mess. But I've been as prepared as I can be, but certain times you ain't prepared for everything.
There's curveballs sometimes, isn't
there? Yeah, there are things that will slap you in the face.
Yeah, sure.
But even in like, for example, I went down to London one time for, I think it was with Mayday and Stretch DCM, MCs from Birmingham, cold guys, just got an EP that came out called Slowgrass. I went down with them to do, because they went out to Japan, it was all funded for, to make music with Japanese grime MCs.
Shit.
So we went down to Radio for represent on Razor, big up Razor, they show on, I think it's every other Tuesday from like 2 to 4 on a Monday, yeah. And we went down to Jay Fresh's show on Pyro. I think I got to London early enough, so I went down to represent first, met the guys and whatnot, Razor. Josie was there, that's how I first met her.
Mm-hmm.
And then Mayday and these, like, they got stuck in traffic quite badly. They got on the show and they had like 10 minutes left, but they made the best out of that 10 minutes. So even when the situation is not going your way, you've got to be a quick thinker as well, and just, yo, how do I puzzle the gap here? Have you got to make a swing here? Have you got to make a right there? Or have you got to go back and do this? That's probably one of the best things that I can say. Because in an industry like this, like, you've got to be able to
think on your feet,
100%, bro. But that comes with experience.
Yeah.
So it depends what your field you're in, you know what I mean? Like, if you're in the SAS, you'd be great for radio. Just saying. But yeah.
Prepare for all eventualities.
Ready for whatever.
Bro, exactly, bro.
Yeah, I've actually got 100 bars written. They're not even written, they're just in my head. I wrote them while I was climbing up Mount Kilimanjaro.
With Steve.
With Steve and them, man.
With Barry.
And he had Barry blue. Rolled down the hill, didn't he?
And he had his blue North Face on, Brexit blue.
Brexit blue?
I'm sorry. I actually saw a North Face. I saw a North Face jacket in a Foot Asylum, and I looked at the colour. Big up Edis. I met him at Foot Asylum. He's a cool brother. I don't know why I turned around and he saw my jacket. He's like, yo, you that's a sick jacket, you know? And I was like, I saw the blue thing. I was like, bro, that's Brexit blue, you know?
What is Brexit blue?
I don't know. I just, you know, when you see them dads, you just clearly look like the racist.
Brexit, no.
And it's just, there's that blue in it. There's that one colour of blue that just looks offensively racist. Maybe that's just me. Maybe I
is
need
it
to
light
just...
blue or dark blue?
I like the
about mid.
Is that Brexit blue?
No. That's good.
That's cool. Yeah.
I like baby blue a lot.
You like baby blue? It's a sports director. Oh, the
That's more of a navy.
Is that more of a?
That's a navy.
That's not a navy. So that's not a Brexit blue.
That's not a Brexit blue.
Okay, cool.
If you know
Sports Direct, you're safe.
You're safe.
But you, you know what? We'll have to when we go to next time. We'll
go B and Q.
We'll go
B and Q. Get a Dulux shot or something. Yeah. We'll put this one to bed once and for all.
Yeah. You'll know which blue I mean. Car. Yeah. You know the North Face that look from 1976 and them in there. Car.
Nice. Cool. Right. Well, without further ado.
Yeah. Do you want to introduce? We're gonna play.
First time, you know.
First time. Radio. I think we want to hear the P Money thing.
Yeah, that's what he's going to play.
We're going to play it. The so P introduce money. It, man.
This is Medley P with my dissection of Excuse Me, Originator. It's a Badman track releasing on an EP called Maya Mills Pack.
Maya Mills.
Chimwan.
Ah, she was like, whoa, it's mad. Don't know what it is, but the feeling's mad. She was like, whoa, it's mad. Don't know what it is, but the feeling's mad. Heavy trackers, this track is mad. Bet when it drops, it'll pull this. I was like, oh, now you like grime. She was like, yeah. I was like, mad. You know who it is, the originator. We ain't got no time for a hater. Love and vibes, fuck a breaker. If you don't know, let me educate ya. I said I'm nice to me, y'all. And it look like my type of raver. The usual boring, blah, blah, blah. Skip a few minutes, dude, it's my number. I said, be honest, you're never bad grime. She was like, not really, nah. Well, there's a party a little later. If you wanna roll out, call me later. I swear down 10 minutes later. Hello? I wanna meet up. I checked you out on Wikipedia. So what time are you picking me up? Cut to the chase, 3 liter. German whip, had a like raw. Baseline pumping, getting deeper. Coming out through the speaker. Pull up at the studio, here we are. I was at Rasta, run a beat, blah. Whatever we do, they wanna feature. It's a good vibe wherever we are. She was like, whoa, it's mad. Don't know what it is, but the feeling's mad. She was like, whoa, it's mad. Don't know what it is, but the feeling's mad. Heavy trackers, this track is mad. Bet when it drops, they'll pull this. I was like, oh, now you like grime. She was like, yeah. I was like, mad. Next location. She was like, whoa, you've been about since MSN and Bebo. She said, P, I'm loving your flow. I said, it's got a little bit of neutrino. You know who that is? She was like, no. I said, you're joking. She was like, no. Picked up my iPod, here you go. Listen to that one. So solid, so. Back to the bits, the man them road. Where OG? You already know. English G's, rolling with Dutch. Gotta bring damn everywhere we go. The party started, come, let's go. You ain't gotta wear no fancy clothes. Look for the people. Eyes paid, here we go. She was like, whoa, it's mad. Don't know what it is, but the feeling's mad. She was like, whoa, it's mad. Don't know what it is, but the feeling's mad. Heavy trackers, this track is mad. Bet when it drops, it'll pull this. I was like, oh, now you like grime. She was like, yeah. I was like, mad. I walked through the door, she was taken away. Like, literally, taken away. Girls wanna dance, more wanna play. Love and vibes, what more can I say? She's only just her grime today. She was like, mad, it's a wave. A friend asked that, what was going? She was like, mad, it's a wave. Now she wants to stay, drinks on us. You ain't gotta pay. DJ spinning, MC spray. One sitter, I turn up my bass.
What a tune that was, eh?
Yeah, very nice. Exquisite stuff. Still got Medley P in the house here.
Vibes in that.
We're here, just cooling. Mm. We made him a cup of tea. He didn't like it. But it's all right. It's cool.
Do you have Earl Grey with sugar? That's the biggest question coming off the back of this session.
I don't think it's a thing. I don't know if certain people do, but personally, I've tried it before and I'm like, nah, this doesn't taste right. Because I think the whole point of Earl Grey is supposed to be that it's the flavour. Do you know what I mean? I think that's, do you know what I mean? You don't get a Fanta and then add sugar to it.
Huh. Unless you're in a bad place.
Unless Fanta's not had the syrup, you know what I'm saying?
That's part of the sugar tax.
Yeah.
Sugar tax?
Sugar tax messed me up, man. You know why? So you used to go Chili Flames, yeah. I used to want to get a Mirinda. Strawberry or something, it's not there, and obviously on delivery you'd have taken that option off. So you have to get that Pepsi or I don't think they do Coke, to be honest.
So Mirinda's illegal now.
I think for Chili Flames they can't do it because of sugar tax.
Oh.
But
sort it out, places, Chili Flames.
But other places they can, because I've been to obviously other Boston shops. I think even Oodle Noodles do.
They do still.
Okay.
So this week we asked the good people over on Insta and Twitter.
Thanks guys.
Send in your submissions. You know, we want to play as much upcoming talent as we can. But obviously we can't play it all. But everyone keeps sending the music in to localgeez@gmail.com. But we've picked a few of our favourites.
Yeah. Top five.
So we're going to start off with...
We're starting off with Synthesize by Harry.
Harry Mellor.
Cheers, Harry.
Tune one. Wealth that you need, just stealth with your cheese, couple E's in your jeans, keep it clean on the beat, all discreet in the streets, not a freak in the sheets, but the beat is speaking to me, and the rhythm is contagious, the prison can't contain us, souls of the people, not the ones they call famous, soul dedication, I'm so dedicated to my own generation, present in the making of the art that's relating to our current situation, currency vacating, we're all money making, stuck up on them wages, hoping for some changes, but no one's here to save us. They're just all here to blame us, haters and make fuss. I've had enough of it, pour a drink, let me dip, let me sit, let me think, let me meditate, I'll elevate and renovate your mindset to levitate. I'll never take the lesser way, I'm effervescent any day. Anyway, I'll demonstrate flows I compose, always come from a better place. Grown in a home where I listen to what my mother say. So I'm here to present my presence, data sense. I lament and frequent on the time that we spent, all the wine that we necked, all the crimes to prevent, all the lies we reject, accept. I'm sick of seeing fake love, people wanna make up. Behind your back they say stuff, stories that they make up to make up the lost love they hate, cause they lost stuff, debating that they bossed us. Payments never cost us, it costs to be free. Though I don't need an ego, my mind floats free, but I'm never gonna free float. Got my own zone, don't ever wanna be cloned. All got a dream, we just all wanna be clothed. Blue tick and be known, smooth whipping grease mode. Who's tipping these hoes, sipping till they've been shown a good time by these blokes, the hood stars and dealers, the real ones will feature. As a young person, it's hard to accept that the life we desire ain't the one we perfect. In school we had friends, right now we got debts. Work every day, but I'm only making sense. In school we worked hard, but we gotta work harder. Life is a lesson like the ones from your father. Bronze on the armor, writing these songs like the wrongs, and I'm calmer, so I'm calmer. See, no one's gonna give it you, go for your dream, then everybody's dissing you. That's why we get stuck in the mud, getting mud like a thug in the hood with a hood. Now you're good but frustrated, you're the only one to change it. Friday will we make it, drink time and wage slipped. I think I've escaped it, then I'm straight in, drinks in, thinking I'm brinking but I'm sinking. A companion of truth, it's a fallacy of youth to reduce, not deduce the profanity of proof. Insanity ensues, so I magically produce these lines so profuse with the product you abuse. Recognition, wanna see Yellowstone, invest in this vision. Depressed but winning on Insta when you're grinning, always sinning. No romance when you're chilling, caught advance in the prison. The proportion of the villains gonna haunt me to the finish, cause we're balling for the figures while the fickle pull the triggers.
Smooth. Very nice. Good content. That's what it's all about, innit?
Exactly, mate.
Good content.
I agree.
Cool. Song number two?
Beanskin.
Yeah, the main
Beanskin.
Man.
Beanskin, yeah.
Main man, definitely, for sure.
One of Derby's up-and-coming talents. He's a local lad.
And this one is called Gone For Good.
Ta-da, bye-bye.
Chim-wai. This life now, gone for good. Fucking with wife now, locking up. Be living right now, without the drugs. I'm out of this life now, gone for good. Shit's going crazy, shit going brazy. I'm living movie scene.
I shot my shot, no drop top. She must have liked my lean. Now we got a house, we got a son. We really living the dream. Before this was dreaming, now I be leaving. Never forgetting the scene. I'm never forgetting my mother. I'm never forgetting my team. I'm never forgetting my brother. I'm never forgetting about me.
We was rolling with the times, late night, smoky vibes. Tryna reach it, but I'm high. Tryna make me feel alive.
I'm out of this life now. Gone for good. Fucking with wife now. Locking up. Be living right now. Without the drugs. I'm out of this life now. Gone for good. Chilling with my son beside me. I'm moving through life at a track speed. Saying hello to the wise bean. It's healthy been hitting the scene. Grinding through this, got a team. I see them when I can free. Got my girl, she let me be. Double cup down, D3. Stay freezing. Stay frozen, cause I'm so cold. It's the only thing I've ever known. I've gotta move on from the shows. I might start fucking up shows. Can't you see my shit done grown? It's what happens when you leave me alone.
It's what happens when you leave me alone.
I'm out of this life now. Gone for good. Fucking with wife now. Locking up. Be living right now. Without the drugs. I'm out of this life now. Gone for good. I'm out of this life now. Gone for good. Fucking with wife now. Locking up. Be living right now. Without the drugs. I'm out of this life now. Gone for good.
And that was Gone For Good. I hope you're not gone for good, Beanskin, because we want to keep hearing more content. All right, mate. I'm moving on to track number three now.
We've got Mr. Herms 4K. London Tekka, London Stylies.
Yep.
This one is Man In The Mirror.
Hey, you know when you've been grinding on something for so long, your eyesight is deception.
Go get lit the stage. Go get lit in stacks. Do for the set me on the way. Go get lit that's fast. Go get lit that's paid. Go get lit in stacks. Do for the youth that be on the way. Go get lit that's fast. Go get lit that's paid. Go get lit in stacks. Do for you.
See that energy you had when you were going mad? Yeah, keep that. Puff out your chest. Let me see your G act. Nah, you don't be that. Yeah, man, I pre that. Chat about tools, you're moving frass. Ain't no goon, you're talking wass. And you don't make walla, that's gas. Yeah. Come like 4000CC. Kawasaki, still on pushback, pattern up B. Move like me. Step in the scene like boom. Give me space, give me room. Then kick down doors. Take your flow like mine, not yours. 4K shake, how on street, but I'll never be a beg. 4K gallus, never been a cheap, but I love me a challenge. 4K and oboe. Young and black, hard pills to swallow. I'm at war with a man in the mirror. Like, yeah, you're real. But I'm realer. Won't ever drop to my knees. View missing her. Devil at my door. Make me a winner. Face my demons. Them days in the dark, bottling feelings, laying on my bed with 1,000 thoughts in my head. What's all worth if my soul ain't in it? My heart bleeds on speed per minute. Revolver on decks, DJ spin it. Be replay, got jump back in it. Bro said kill him, so I did it. Click, clack, bars get slapped. Boom, bow, dump that round. Skid, skirt, moving dirt. Track, mash, rack up cash. Go get Lizzie, that's facts. Go get Lizzie, that's bae. Go get Lizzie in stacks. Do it for the youth that be on the way. Like raw herm, swear that's you. Nah, bro, I'm not that dude. But you never know too, so go get Lizzie in bundles. Been getting Lizzie from day. When you get Lizzie, stay humble. Do it for the youth that be on the way. Go get Lizzie, that's facts. Go get Lizzie, that's bae. Go get Lizzie, that's stacks. Do it for the youth that be on the way. Go get Lizzie, that's facts. Go get Lizzie, that's bae. Go get Lizzie, that's stacks. Do it for the youth that be on the way.
What an elegant bop.
It certainly was, wasn't it? Elegant bop, that's what it's all about. You know, you hear Man in the Mirror, you think Michael Jackson, that was a good song. And he's not disappointed here either with this Man in the Mirror.
It'll be
Thumbs up to you, buddy.
He'll be Millie rocking in his grave.
Hey!
Bringing it straight back to Derby, though. We've got who should we go for first? Chani.
Yeah, Chani.
This one just dropped on Mixtape Madness. Some real wavy visuals
to go with it.
Yeah. Double double.
Chimwad.
I got two phones, yeah, yeah. I got two hoes, yeah, yeah. I got two hoes, yeah, yeah, that's double freaks. I got two phones, yeah, yeah, that's double D's. Check my belt, yeah, oh, it's a double G. She can't get enough, yeah, she want double me. I took off a bra, yeah, it's a double D. I put me a double cup and now I'm feeling lean. I said, now I'm feeling lean. I said, now I'm feeling lean. I need a bag, 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 I need a cake. They going outside, side, 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 get on my face. They saving these hoes, they saving these hoes, gonna pass them a cake. Get on my way, yeah, the paper chase, yeah. I cost more that we cost, so that we be late. It's my birthday every day, cause I'm out here getting cake. In the German coupe, I'm swerving, switching lanes. In the German coupe, I'm swerving, switching lanes. Drip here in Gucci and Dior. Crack the window, shut that door. Baby, get down on the fours. Know you're fucking with the boss. I don't care about what the cost. Anything she wanna cop. Anything she wanna cop. Does that 5-0. Cause what's up in the whip like be like 5-0s. And the money go wherever I go. Take a hit, I'm feeling high, oh, oh. Got your bitch rubbing my thighs, whoa, whoa. And I know just what she like, oh, oh. I know just what she like, oh, oh. I know just what she like, yeah, I know just what she like. I got two hoes, yeah, yeah, that's double freaks. I got two phones, yeah, yeah, that's double D's. Check my belt, yeah, oh, it's a double G. She can't get enough, yeah, she want double me. I took off a bra, yeah, it's a double D. I put me a double cup and now I'm feeling lean. I said now I'm feeling lean. Said now I'm feeling lean. You know I'm so wavy. Drive these bitches crazy. This 41 not HG. I'm in a coupe. I'm with your boo. She blowin' my dick like balloon. They need to learn. So I just took them to school. This jet that I'm wearing, I swear that it's keeping me cool. I swear that it's keeping me cool. I got two hoes, yeah, yeah, that's double freaks. I got two phones, yeah, yeah, that's double D's. Check my belt, yeah, oh, it's a double G. She can't get enough, yeah, she want double me. I took off a bra, yeah, it's a double D. I put me a double cup and now I'm feeling lean. I said, now I'm feeling lean. I said, now I'm feeling lean.
Make sure you guys go and check the visuals out for that one. It's you don't want to be missing out on that one, honestly. And finally, last but not least, Gunfingers, aka Medley P. Do you want to introduce it?
It's my guy, AO19 from early, yeah. Don't know, he's got his new track out, Chase. The visuals, bro, he's went more than into town, bro.
They're crazy.
Shut down still.
Crazy.
Harrods thing, bro.
Crazy.
Like, crazy. I was shocked when I saw it. I was like, yo, I know he's doing good. So I was like, I'm glad to see that, man. And he's got his own little wave going on right now. I know he's working with some good people there. So, you know what I mean? And his productions in general, crazy. So people, them, look out, listen, lock your ears into that one, AO19, Chase.
Chimwad.
I chase the guap. In the city they can't save a lot, but I plant like a seed, I'm gonna see a lot. Searching for my blessings, but I can't get the drop. Yeah, I'm flexing, don't forget, that's big flex, I can't stop. Too many songs on the block, that's where we stay posted up. Busties in the back and they stay loaded up. And they sweating, no it's us. I had to cheat check their buff. I had to re-up on some stuff. Fantasy flavors, pixie dust. Had to sell all my debts, but the cash flow wasn't enough. Doing a crime with intent, no mask, so they know we're tough. Yeah, living my life in effect.
But when I know how I flex, man, one of the best. No rest, no sleep. If I speak, I say it with chest. Looking at what I've achieved, that's why I know I'm really up next. Doing G's, no less. Stay out of sight, stay out of my mind. Don't call my phone, don't call my line. Tell them I gotta go get it, I gotta go get it. Inspector could go do it different. I cannot fight them, call like a blizzard, they gonna see. I make a boom on the track, straight to the moon, never land. Top of the coupe and we gassed up like we filled a few tanks. I know that 5 minutes won't last long, but they still do what they can. I'ma go fly off to Milan. But first, I need a taste, I need a chase. I chase a lot. I chase the guap. In the city, they can't save a lot, but I plan like a seed. I can see a lot. I'm searching for my blessings, but I can't get the drop. Yeah, I'm flexing, don't forget, that's big flex, I can't stop. Too many summers on the block, that's where we stay posted up. The justice at the back and they stay loaded up. And it's stay loaded up.
You know what it is, Medley P, bro. That was my guy, AO19 with Chase. And you know what? That is sadly the end of the show. Little baby. It's been the end of a chinwag, and I think we've definitely had a good chinwag.
Good old chinwag, oh, yeah. Over a couple of teas.
My jaw is hurting, you know, and I'm not doing any dodgy drugs, I tell you that.
It's staying quiet still.
Yeah. Well, yeah, for episode 3, Medley P, Local Geezers, signing out. Until next time, folks.
Bye.
Geezer gang.